This is your life.
Robert Redford, Christian Slater. A lot of people were born on the same day as you. And you know what? Some of them are actually talented. Patrick Swayze, Shelley Winters. Talent had to go somewhere on that day. Anyway, and then Malcolm Jamal Warner. And then we have Karen Rossborn on this year. Yeah, she's been responsible for her existence. They are Marianne Milsick and Matthew John Milsick Sr.
Last year.
It's this summer. Inspiration for this event. So we've had practice. First, I would like to bring onto the stage Marianne Milsick, who has something to say about her wonderful and dear daughter. So welcome her onto the stage.
Thank you. She started out a rebel. She did. When she was about 3 years old, she packed her dog clothes and walked down the street. She wanted a new mommy. Because her mommy was too mean. I made arrangements with the lady down the street, and she walked down the street politely, and it was quite a distance too. And she found a new mommy. But that mommy was as mean as I was, maybe more so. So she trotted on back, and we made up, and we loved each other. And I forgot there was something else I wanted to say. Anyway, I have a godly daughter, and I'm so proud of her because she's committed to the Lord. And yes, thank you, Lord, for a committed Christian. And I'm really proud of her.
Should we tell I've never used one of these before? Matthew John Milsick Sr. is going to sing something for Karen. So please welcome him.
Before I sing something, I have.
Guns and family books.
This is going to go, Karen. I know that she is highly independent, willing to take care of herself and others as much as she can. When she was 4 years old, she found out that when she was sick or had a fever or a headache, her mother would give her one little St. Joseph baby aspirin. Well, this independent young lady, one morning, decided she had a headache. So she went and got the St. Joseph aspirin bottle out of the closet, and she took it. Her headache didn't go away, so she took another one, until she had finally consumed 23 of them, and ended up at the hospital getting her stomach pumped. But regardless of all of that, she's still my little girl.
Cue music.
Okay.
Sounds off.
Shouldn't be.
What you are, your money's bright and shining sun. You're the spirit of Christmas, my star on the tree. When Easter Bunny to Mommy and me, your sugar, your spice, your everything nice, and your levees, little girl. You're the end of the rainbow, my pot of gold, the daddy's little girl.
Six, and we were living in the house in Brunswick, and Mom was sick. You decided to help out cooking dinner one night. So she puts a can of beans on the stove to warm up. She was still fairly young and not really all that bright. So
she things never change.
Yes, well, that's true too. She neglected to open the can, which the stove promptly took care of for her. And as a result, the entire kitchen, dining room, inside cabinets, everything on the tables, of course, was pelted and bonded together with baked beans. Imagine how much we appreciated that. He also destroyed my Roy Rogers notebook, which I've never really gotten over. that was real traumatic for me. But I love it anyway, and one wish you happy birthday, you old bag.
Next up in line, we have Edwina Milicic. She was the next born. So welcome her on to the stage. I'm sure she's going to be very well.
Actually, I don't have a lot much to say. I thought I'd explain to the people here that this was before my time, of course, but when Karen was about a year old, my dad's Uncle Ray saw her, kicking and running around, carrying up a storm. He says, "That's not Karen Ann, that's carrying on." So now that went from carrying on to carrying nanny to nanny. That's why we were singing, "Every nanny wants to rule the world." Happy birthday, babe.
Next is Milo, Mark Milicic, Mark Allen. Oh, that's your middle name.
Yes, it is.
So your initials are Ma'am?
Ma'am, just like your grandmother.
Yep.
Don't bust me too hard because I'll sick, or I need.
So Milo.
Milo's
so
good.
That's the name of a pet, right?
Your cat, right.
Yeah, well.
I had it first, anyway. But I had something picked out over the last couple of weeks, and I kind of got my thunder stolen because it was something that happened when I was 11 or 12, and I just can't say it here. Doggone it. But anyway, I just wanted you to know that, I mean, you have been an immeasurable help to me throughout the course of my life, dear. And if you ever question whether your ministry and what you were all about has ever changed anybody's life, know that you did mine.
Amen.
And that I probably wouldn't be standing here talking if it wasn't for the counseling that I got from you, my lovely sister. So God bless you. Microphone on a stand and gather around it.
To explain what's going on, these guys are going to present to you an arrangement of Coyote Howls that this family likes to call music.
Coyote Howls!
I don't think I need to for you were
going to. He used to be my song.
Coyote Howls.
Wow.
Ready? One, two, three, and.
You laugh out loud, the dog laughs.
good family.
Yes, it is. It isn't until you leave here.
Ah! Old man over there thinks he's going to take me. Anyway.
There's more of us than there are of you. Yes, she found it. All I got to do is fall on you.
At any rate, Karen had children, as some of you may know. And they, some of them have some things to say, some of them have some very funny things to say. So let's bring them on up here. We got Farrakish, Kristen Kish, and Michael Ben, who is currently serving on the Kingdom.
Yes.
Yes, over by North Korea.
Well,
or South Korea.
Michael, unfortunately, was not able to be here. As you guys know, he's serving out on the Kitty Hawk. Hey, bud. But I do have a message from him to you, Mother, and it reads like this. Hello, Mom. I wish I could be there to celebrate your 50th birthday. Unfortunately, I have matters of national security to attend to. I wish I could bring you Saddam's head on a platter for your birthday, but it would take too long to deliver, and it would start to smell bad. I love you, Mom. You are the best, and I'll be home soon. Now, I've got a few things that I want to say.
Why didn't you let the girls go first?
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm going to say happy birthday to
Mom. And the translation of that is happy birthday, Mom. Stop touching my butt.
Not going to say anything.
But I am. Alright, well, first of all, Mom, let me start off nice. I do want to congratulate you on 50 years of survival, and only half of that was with me. 25 years, I came into your life, and then there was Dad, and then, of course, Farrah was already there, and then Michael. And Mom had to deal with three guys that were more full of testosterone than any one man should have at any time. How many pieces of furniture do you think between Michael and I that we broke in our house? Well, you know, the couch was the end zone, and the end tables were the things that we would jump off of, and, you know, if the lamps fell, the lamps fell. But, Mom, you know, you amaze me because you put up with us. I mean, me, she raised all of us, you know, and she ruled us like, apparently she rules you guys. We couldn't get away with anything. But you know, I was so surprised because Mom, she went through Dad and Michael and myself and didn't grow a gray hair at all. And you know, it amazed me. How does Mom do that? Look at Dad. Okay? He started when he was 30. Okay?
Stand up, Mike.
Yeah. And Mom, you know, she put up with more than Dad did with us, because, you know, yeah.
She has this aristocratic friend.
Oh, yeah, I think I have a picture of her, as a matter of fact. Yeah, it's Lady Clairol that helped her not to go away. She did have some help, so I got that for you, Mom. You're welcome. But, you know, Mom brings this up all the time. She calls me, you know, once or twice a week, and she's always asking me, oh, you have anybody special in your life? Are you married? Are you getting married? No. Oh, don't lie. Don't lie. Okay? No. And you know what? I used to lose a lot of sleep over this because, you know, I'm thinking, hey, what's wrong with that? I can't. Just my luck always runs out, it just seems. It just never works out. But, you know, I used to think that it was my fault. But, Mom, it's your fault. It's your fault that I'm not married. Let me tell you why. Every guy, whether they realize it or not, they're out to land somebody that's like their mom, okay? Now, Mom, you just set the bar too high. Way too high. How can I find somebody that is the enigma? One day I was so forlorn about this whole thing, and I actually got online and took a personality test, find your match or whatever, okay? That's how desperate I was. Okay, so I get on there, the result is, your woman is an enigma, which is something that is very hard to find, and that's Mom. Am I not right, Dad?
Right.
Absolutely right. So, you know, I think about this, okay, Mom is the enigma. She can be anything. She's got logic, and she's got such a great personality that when you're troubled, you can talk to Mom, and she will calm your heart. But at the same time, if you trouble Mom, she's got the wit and the brevity to just slash you up with her tongue. How do you find a woman that can do both things? How do you find a woman that can sing like a bird and just bless your heart, but at the same time, scream like a banshee and make it leap out of your chest?
Do not clean your bed. Put the clothes away.
That's what I dealt with growing up. And, you know, one thing about Mom, okay? She can sing, yes. But her hands, she works so well with her hands. She can type 120 words a minute. She can play the piano very, very well. And she has these hands that she decorates with, she gardens with. She works very, very well with those hands. And this is a woman that has these hands that are precious to her, but is also willing to dip these cans into a hand of, dip these hands into a can of paint when we were kids. And we had a whitewashed wall in the basement of Alliance. And this woman, just to make sure her kids would learn discipline, and, you know, we had problems when we were kids. We could never put our hands on the wall in the right place. We were always up here, down here, or out here. So Mom decides one day she's going to put her hands in a can of paint and put them on the wall in a perfect spot. Just like this. Just so her children would learn how to be disciplined properly. How do you find a woman like that? So Mom, you set the bar too high. And actually, I think I'm going to have to start lowering my standards, and I'm going to go after Miss America. Until I do get married, Mom, you're going to remain my girl. We got yelling almost every day until our chores were done. We couldn't go out and play. Well, I guess you'll say what made us turn out this way. Mother,
mother,
talking about mother,
mother.
You would paddle us whenever we were bad.
Between your spouse and you. He's very tall and not. You let his hair go gray, you're fighting it tooth and nail. He's got a very low, calm voice, and his laugh is very subtle. When you laugh, I want to leave the room. So, without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, I give you Pastor Michael Scott Ross.
I sit on the sidelines when I go to the family reunions. I just am entertained. It's beautiful. But there's a song that Karen knows, and it kind of goes along with "My Corona," which means "My Crown." Okay. Is this what I'm doing?
Yes.
Okay. So however I do this,
just watch for your cue. Okay.
All right. And this is okay. Here's a rundown on some of the lyrics. All right.
We have the music.
It's gonna be okay. Yeah, it's gonna be up on the screen too.
So you gotta understand, Karen Ross is a very interesting. Let me tell you. Let me just give you this before we humiliate her. I'll tell you what. I prayed Proverbs 31. God told me that someday I would have a Proverbs 31 woman, and you know, that's a pretty high order. But you know, the difference was this: is that God said, "You can't bring it about. I will do it."
But it won't start.
And so that's why it's patience. And I'll tell you what, Karen Ross has helped me so much in my life. She is, you know, the lie would be that I raised Karen. Karen, we know, raised me. You know, we know that. And I'm just so grateful and thankful that she had the humility to marry me. And I really mean that. Because, you know, some guys, you know, when we were younger, I used to wonder, you know, Lord, am I worthy of such a girl? And I just thank God that He chose to let her in my life. Amen?
Amen.
Okay. With that, am I doing this?
Yes, you are.
Wait, we got to start the music. Well, look to Milo for your
music. All right. I'm looking to
Milo.
Wait,
don't start yet. Dance, Mike.
Yeah, I know the song. Alright. Karen, you're my darling wife, and you're the jewel in my corona. You're such a special girl, love you so, I'm with you and I never frown. Corona. I never stop, give it up, such a sweetie pie. Always bring me up when you smile, I'm a lucky guy. My, woo! Woo! My Corona. Yeah, this is something. Have you ever been here? Have you ever seen her when she's in work mode? Better get out of her way. Corona. She gets single-minded when she's working and typing and rehearsing that play. Corona. Never stop, never give up. When she's in work mode, always gets it done, even when it's a heavy load. My, woo! My, Corona. Happy birthday to you, babe, sweetie pie. And we all just want to take time, Corona, to say how we love you, babe, sweetie pie. I feel like Vegas. We know that you're really going to be fine, Corona. Never stop, give it up. You'll get older now. It may always be older than all of us. Especially me, I want you to know that. My, you're old, wow. You're a classic now, Corona. Older than dirt, Corona. You're like dust, okay, Corona. Older than us, Corona. Bye, Corona.
Personality like that.
Ladies and gentlemen, you can see Pastor Mike Scott Ross at every Sunday. All right. This next portion of the show is for your friends. I know very little about your friends. done, so this part of the show is going to have very little commentary from me, much to the delight of our audience.
Is Sheila here? Okay. And Doris can't make it either, because you know what? Doris's brother's 50th birthday party was here, was going on tonight, and he hadn't shown up yet.
Well, he's still trying to be 49.
Still trying to be 49. Karen Weber, where are you?
Come on up here.
Just a little while. I just wanted to give you a couple meanings of your name. Karen, your name means warm-hearted, pure, beloved. But I have some other names for you too. You stop thinking that! I mean, confidant, encourager, and a living example. See, Sheila was supposed to do this. Thank you. Props. But the most precious name that's closest to my heart is friend.
Time, we would like to welcome James Bean Company up to the stage.
The James Bean Company, I like that.
I've never heard that a thousand times.
You most certainly can, sir.
Oh, shoot. Jim, where's Jim? Where's Jim? The guy with the mic.
Well, anyway, while they're getting situated, I have a little story to tell about Karen. A couple years back, well, several years, I had the privilege of attending a seminar down in Nashville, Tennessee, with Karen and another one of our friends. But we had a blast. Karen is a lot of fun to be with. She really is. And we laughed all the way down. Well, since we had gotten our reservations in late, a lot of the hotels were already booked, so they had to give us a room, and we requested non-smoking. So we had a huge king-size bed and then a sofa couch. Well, our friend Mary decided she would take the sofa couch, and Karen and I got to share the big king-size bed. Now, you think a king-size bed would be plenty of room, you know. Well, all night long, I feel these feet against my back pushing me, and I'm on the very edge of this huge bed, and I look over, and here's Karen, lengthwise, crossways, like this. Now, see, now that I know what you're really like, that explains it. I love you, Karen. You have been such a strength to me over these years, and you are wise beyond your years. Biblical wisdom you have given me. And I thank you for your friendship.
Okay, he'll take his mic. Okay, we'd like for those who have not been up here yet to share, to be a part of our song, okay? So I'm gonna sing, "You've Got a Friend in Me," and then Tammy's gonna say "We," and then the boys are gonna say
"Us."
Okay, get over there, help them. So I want you to do the "us" part with them. Let's practice. "You've got a friend in me."
We.
Us.
You got it?
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
Next slide.
We'll try it. You got it. Aw, perfect.
Jim.
Okay. Oh, you need me? Time. You've got a friend in me.
We. Us.
You've got. Just remember what I said, 'cause you've got a friend in me. pretty good. You got a friend in me.
We are.
You got a friend in me.
We are.
If you got troubles, I've got them too. There isn't anything I wouldn't do for you. We stick together, we can see it through. Cause you got a friend in me.
We are.
You got a friend in me.
We are.
Some other folks might be a little bit smarter than I am, bigger and stronger too. But that doesn't mean that they care the way we do, the way we do. And as the years go by, our friendship will never die. You're gonna see it's our destiny, cause you've got a friend in me.
We are!
You've got a friend in me.
We are!
You've got a friend in me.
We are!
Everybody count to three, happy birthday. One, two, three.
Please rise for the singing of A Mighty Old Broad is Karen Ross.
She's in work mode. Her car. Sisters with bright, cordial smiles. They promptly let me know that if anything ever happened to Sheena, any harm came to her, they would kill me. The guys were just nuts. Really. So when I was approached to contribute to this little bash, needless to say, I felt like it was an offer I couldn't refuse. So, out of trouble here just in it was tough finding things older than Karen Ross. But after a few minutes of exhaustive research, I was able to come up with a few things older than Karen. The pyramids of the Egyptian plain. Those are really old. The Great Wall of China predates Karen Ross by at least a couple of dozen decades. The Leaning Tower of Pisa. While the tower's construction was completed before Karen's birth, I was unable to verify exactly how long that tower's been leaning. The Colosseum, a very famous building. Every city wants one and a pro sports team to fill the seats. But the original, well, is older than Karen Ross. Now, this one was a close call. The Liberty Bell. But rest assured, the Liberty Bell was letting freedom ring before Matt and Marianne were blessed with Karen. You know, also, I noticed from the presentation that Sir Edmund Hillary reached the summit of Mount Everest in the same year that Karen was born. Mount Everest is actually older than Karen. And one last thing. The wisdom that Karen possesses is well beyond her years. We love you very much.
Your future. It is time, ladies and gentlemen, for the lighting of the bonfire.
You might want to put on your sunglasses now.
fuzzy gifts for next?
Well, you're just going to let people know what's in the back.
Oh, okay, right. We've got refreshments in the fellowship hall. There's going to be gifts there. There's also going to be a jam session in here if you want to hear some really loud music. And at this time, with the lasers, Rosses and Millicicks come to the front for the traditional family benediction.
We love you, Karen. Honor you. Respect you.
Embarrass you.
Wait to embarrass you. And we all rejoice that we're not as old as you.
You're coming up and singing this with us.
Yes, yes. Please. Because we need you to be our soprano. Yeah.
Well, we all got to be over here, I guess. Decade.